with Nintendo soon to close down the Wii Shop, this might be your very last chance to get some awesome games. So I am the Game Collector, and this is Second Opinion Games, and today we count down the top 10 gems of the WiiWare. Because quite a bit of them are really, really good, and I don't want you to get stuck with a stinker like this game on the screen. So let's start it right now!
Second Opinion Games.
Number 10. Sexy Poker. Oh yes, this game definitely deserves to be on this list just because it officially announced Nintendo removing the stick from its butt when it comes to pretty girls getting their clothes off. So you can play blackjack here, and it is very, very boring. Occasionally, you will see a girl lose her top. You can also play Texas Hold'em, which is far more interesting on this game. You could rake in the money a lot quicker, which means you're going to unlock tons more girls really, really fast. Overall, the game plays just fine, and we finally get to see partial nudity on a Nintendo console, which is pretty much what all Nintendo consoles were sorely missing up until this point.
Looks like I have to remove some clothes.
Number 9. Eduardo the Samurai Toaster. I love me a really good run and gun, and that's what you get here. On top of it, it's the art style, the mood that really draws you into the game. The music totally sets the tone, and it really pulls you in. Now you can play this game up to 4-player co-op at the same time, and that's really how you should be playing it. It is really good. It mixes things up by sometimes moving as an auto-scroller, sometimes moving vertically, or just left to right. You could even pick up enemy projectiles and throw them back at the bosses, which is pretty much what you need to do in some states. There are tons of different power-ups, and the game is just amazingly fun, even if it does sound somewhat silly. Now let's hope Franklin, the ninja Cuisinart, comes out real soon. Number 8. Doc Lewis Punch-Out. Okay, full cards on the table. I love Punch-Out, and Doc Lewis, your trainer, is one of my most favorite characters of all time, even before the Wii version of Punch-Out came out. So here he is, and I don't want to fight him, I just want to hug the guy. He is so full of character, and I absolutely love this. Seeing him train Little Mac is amazing, and I love his one-liners. On top of it, he eats chocolate in the ring. Who doesn't love Doc Lewis? And he even shows off his awesome Star Punch. I love this game, even if it is really horrible for me because it's so darn short and I completely stink at it. Now this was a Club Nintendo exclusive, so maybe you can't get your hands on this game, which I fully understand because it frustrates me how more people haven't played it, and why can't Nintendo just release it for everyone or just make it its own standalone game because it's freaking awesome. Man, I love Doc Lewis. Just give him his own game, please, or at least his own amiibo, or maybe even throw him in Smash Brothers. Is that too much to ask? Come on! Number 7. Chrono Twins. Two 2D screens at the same time would kind of make this the first, or one of the first, 4D games? I don't know. It's an action run and gun with a ton of puzzle elements. Matter of fact, it's more puzzle than anything else. Even though you'll do plenty of shooting, you have a charge shot or just your standard laser, and you have to pay very close attention to what's going on the top screen and the bottom screen if you have any chance of survival. Now jumping into the pits doesn't mean you're gonna die right away. You have a little bit of a health bar in the corner, but you're gonna be frustrated just when you fall short of that checkpoint every single time. This will really test your mental acuity, and oh my god, just look at it. It plays great. Just don't play it too long, or your brain will melt. Number 6. Cave Story. here's an RPG that's sort of like Metroid. There's a little bit of backtracking here and there, but the real draw is getting new weapons, powering them up, and defeating a boss. And then, rinse, cycle, repeat, the game opens up great. I love the graphical art style, which really was new at the time and now seems to be trending. I think it was an early trendsetter. This game was made by one guy, and it took many years to pull it off, so let's give him a lot of support. Buy it again for the DS, the 3DS, or even the Nintendo Switch, but certainly buy it for the WiiWare before it's gone for good. There is so much gameplay here, including even a boss rush mode, where you could truly test your skills. Now let's just hope that EA doesn't buy it and turn into a first-person shooter. Number 5. Tetris Party. Tetris makes a truly great party game because you and three of your friends could be playing Tetris to see who the real master of puzzles is. However, I don't have any friends, so I could always challenge the computer and trash talk that for a while. There's also other modes to play, including maybe filling in a picture, which will truly test your skills because, man, is it ever hard. Or you could just help this little guy reach the very, very top, which is kind of weird because you have to retrain your brain not to play Tetris. That's rough. This is an incredible game. You also could have substituted Dr. Mario in here, but I'm a little bit better at Tetris than I am Dr. Mario because, man, I just don't like taking all those pills. Number 4. Castlevania Rebirth. Now, I strongly recommend you get every single one of the Rebirth games. However, on this slot, I'm going with Castlevania Rebirth because they really brought Castlevania back to a true form. Now, falling in pits doesn't mean death in Castlevania here, it just means a branching path. And that's really where this game shines, all the different branching paths. I must have played through it at least 6 times, and I guarantee you every single time I found new levels and new ways to play the game. Picking up keys to finding locked doors is unbelievably satisfying. Even falling into a pit to find a new level that I've never played before is great. The monsters are back in full effect, and the boss battles are more epic than ever. And who doesn't like picking up that orb just to hear those sweet Castlevania chimes? Number 3. Zombie Panic in Wonderland. I'm not going to be satisfied until all the zombies are dead. And that's why this game truly shines, because I could pick up a submachine gun and mow down tons and tons of the undead. I could also pick up a flamethrower or a grenade launcher to really destroy those undead creatures of the night. Heck, even birds attack you in this game. If you like wild guns, you absolutely owe it to yourself to get this because it plays almost exactly the same. Your character flips around like a ninja to dodge attacks, and it is completely satisfying leveling a town just trying to kill a couple members of the undead. Its overall creepy Halloween theme is terrific, and there's even a little bit of story here, maybe even some gnomes running around. Well, I really hate those gnomes, so I'm just gonna try and shoot them every chance I get. Because, you know, maybe they have some magical vases hanging around. Number 2. World of Goo. Now here's a puzzle game that will sometimes have you scratch your head. It might take a couple of minutes to get used to the gameplay here, but before you know it, you'll be building towers and bridges, and then trying to figure out how to scale the side of a hill using only these weird little gluey blocks. Be careful not to send your glue into some spinning blades or they'll die and you won't get them back. After all, the goal is to save them by reaching a faucet, usually around the top of the screen. This puzzle game is epic. Sometimes you won't figure out a board for many days of continuous trying just to set it down, pick it up later, and get it on your very first try. I'm not going to show off much of the first couple levels here because it truly is a puzzle game and I want you to get full enjoyment out of it. So, just take my opinion for it. Thanks for watching. Oh wait, here comes number one. Number one, Rage of the Gladiator. Now maybe I mentioned this before, but I'm a Punch-Out fan, and guess what? This game is Punch-Out Gladiator style. Add on a story, maybe even some magic, and power-ups after every single level where you could rank up different trees to fit your needs and overall gameplay style. Maybe you want regenerating health, or maybe it's more important for you to take a couple more percentage points out of your opponent. There's even combos that you could use to unleash pure disaster on your enemies. Now there isn't rounds like boxing, instead, every single time you knock the enemy down, he'll get back up with more attacks, and more moves, and stronger ones. This game is a Punch-Out clone done absolutely right, and that's why it is my pick for the best gem of the WiiWare. But that's just my opinion. Thanks for watching.
Why won't you look at me? If you won't let me, no one will.
Am I moving too fast for you?
Hello, and hopefully you really like this list. I know you didn't agree with it because everyone's needs are different, but I just wanted to give you guys some ideas of some of the great WiiWare games that are out there. Hopefully you're not watching this after the WiiWare was shut down and you have access to these great games, why they're still there. I know it might be a little bit too late to support some of these small development teams, but the games are really, really good, even if they're not in physical copies. So, please, let me know what WiiWare games you want to see full reviews of in the future. And until later, I'll see you again, guys.